Hello friends, welcome to all. Today we will discuss about power quality issues. What are the basic requirements for critical loads? So, very basic requirement for any industry is continuous or no break in power. Another one is voltage regulation, then sine wave supply, isolation and constant frequency. Now understanding reactive power and power factor. What is power factor? Power factor is nothing but is the cosine of angle between voltage and current. Here we have taken three cases. In first case, load is resistive type load. So the power factor of resistive type load is always unity. Here we can see the red and blue waveforms. And both waveforms are in phase. It means phase difference between these two is zero. So the power factor for the resistive type load is unity. Now see the inductive type load. In this type load, power factor is always less than unity. We can see the phase difference between red and blue waveform. So power factor of this type of load is always less than unity. And in the RL load also there is a phase difference between voltage and current. So power factor of RL load is always less than unity. So from this we can say that in any inductive load there is a power factor is less than unity. Displacement power factor. Ratio of the active power of the fundamental in watts to the apparent power of the fundamental wave in volt amperes. True power factor, ratio of the total power in watts to the total volt amperes. This includes fundamentals and all harmonic components. Now understanding Christ factor, it is related to peak value. Christ factor is equal to peak amplitude divided by RMS value. Here we can see this is the peak of waveform. So it defines the peak value of the waveform. Now understanding harmonics. Harmonics will present in nonlinear type load. Any power electronics converters are nonlinear load. So in this case, there is any power electronics converter will be there. Here we can see three types of loads, waveforms, red, blue and green. Red waveform stands for fundamental wave, blue waveform stands for third harmonic component, and green waveform stands for resultant of first and third harmonic component. Now what is nth harmonic? If we define nth harmonic, then its amplitude will be fundamental amplitude divided by n, and frequency of the nth harmonic will be multiplied by n. It means fundamental frequency into n. So this way we can define nth harmonic of the waveform. For example, in third harmonic there is a amplitude is fundamental component divided by 3, and its frequency is fundamental frequency into 3. Sinusoidal component having a frequency that is an integral multiple of the fundamental frequency. Total harmonic distortion. It defines the total harmonic content of the current or voltage. Ratio of the RMS of the harmonic content to the RMS of the fundamental as a percentage of fundamental. So THD is equal to under root sum of squares of amplitude of all harmonics divided by square of amplitude of fundamental into 100. And mathematically we can say that THD is equal to sigma H is equal to 2 to infinity under root VH square divided by V1 square into 100. So this way we can find the harmonic content of current or voltage. power quality. Supply voltage at load must have fundamental component only, be balanced, have declared magnitude under all conditions. The voltage at any point in the distribution system is uniquely described by V of t is equal to Vm sin omega t. It means root 2 into V into sin 2 pi f t. Power quality affected by polluting load. So here question arises, what is polluting load? Okay, polluting. So polluting load means non-linear load. Any power electronics converter is a type of polluting load because it injects harmonics in the system. So here we can see the diode symbol in the load. It means there is a rectifier or any power electronics converter is there. So we can see the waveform is distorted. Input waveform is pure sinusoidal, but the output side of the waveform is distorted. So this is the effect of polluting load. Common power quality disturbances. So here we have list out the different power quality disturbances. First one is reactive power demand, harmonic distortion, voltage sags and swells, under voltages and over voltages, voltage unbalance, voltage flicker, voltage notching, voltage interruption, transient disturbances and frequency variations. Now we will see all these disturbances in some details. Harmonic polluting loads. What are the harmonic polluting loads? So I have mentioned earlier that all the power electronics converters are harmonic polluting loads. Rectifiers, arc furnaces and adjustable speed drives. These are the cases of harmonic polluting load. Harmonics FFT analysis. FFT means fast Fourier transform analysis. So if we have to find the harmonics content in any system, we have to do FFT analysis in CRO. Here we have take two case. First case is current drawn by PC and a waveform. We can see the waveform and below that harmonic spectrum of PC current waveform. We can say that here is the third and fifth components are present in the current drawn by PC and its value is also higher. And in second case, 6 pulse converter or battery charger. So in 6 pulse converter, we can see the 3 pulse in positive up cycle and 3 pulse in negative up cycle. So all for all one cycle, there are 6 pulses. And harmonic spectrum of 6 pulses converter, there is no third harmonic component. So it is the advantage of the 6 pulse converter. And fifth harmonic component is also less than 20%. So conclusion is, which one is better? 6 pulse converter is better than single phase. Now implication of reactive and harmonic currents. Oversize of all installation equipments to transmit reactive and harmonic currents, namely transformers, cables, circuit breakers and distribution switchboards. Neutral overloads, increase in transmission and distribution loads, reduction in voltage stability margin, overheating and loss of life and equipments. So if we consider all these things, then major increase in cost will be there. Voltage sags and swells. Reduction in the AC voltage at the power frequency for durations from a half cycle to few seconds. This will be considered as sag. Voltage sag is characterized by two parameters, magnitude and duration. In the below figure, we can see this portion is, you can see the amplitude is lower than the normal value. So we can say that this portion is voltage sag. In this case also, voltage sag you can observe in the middle of the waveform, and this will be the voltage swell. So in the voltage swell, amplitude of the voltage will be increases for some cycles. Power electronics loads are sensitive to voltage sags. Cases of voltage sags and swells. Cases for sag: motor starting, transformer energization, and transmission line faults. These are the cases for voltage sag. Now, cases for voltage swell: single line to ground fault, removing a large load, or adding a large capacitor bank. So these are the cases for voltage swell. Now, voltage unbalance. Definition: in a balanced sinusoidal supply system, the three line neutral voltages are equal in magnitude and are phase displaced from each other by 120 degrees. Here you can see the phase diagram of balanced system. R, Y, and B, these three are phases, and the phase difference between all these three are 120 degree. So this is called as balanced system, and this one is the unbalanced system. Here we can observe that phase difference between R and Y is 119 degree. Phase difference between blue and yellow is 121 degree. So there is a phase difference between these two. So it is, we can consider this as an unbalanced system. Cases for unbalance: unequal system impedances, unequal distribution of single phase loads, phase to phase loads, unbalanced three phase loads. So these are the cases for unbalance. Now, effect of voltage unbalance. Induction motor drive. What are the effect of voltage unbalance on induction motor drive? Overheating and loss of insulation life, reduced motor efficiency, noisy in their operation due to torque and speed pulsations, motor derating. So these are the effects of voltage unbalance on induction motor drive. Now, AC variable speed drive. So effect of voltage unbalance on AC drive. Here you can see three cases: line current of three phase diode rectifier for balanced input. So in this case we can see the waveform of our input, balanced input. In second case, line current of three phase diode rectifier for 5% unbalanced input. So in this case the waveform is distorted somewhat. We can compare these two, first one and this. And the last case is line current of three phase diode rectifier for 15% unbalanced input. If we compare this last case with first, we can see the one pulse is disappeared from the positive cycle and one pulse is disappeared from the negative cycle. So there is a loss of energy. Draws uncharacteristic triplet harmonics. Triplet harmonic current can lead to undesirable harmonic problems. Excessive thermal stress on diodes. These are the effects of voltage unbalance on AC drive. Voltage flicker. Repetitive or random variations of the voltage envelope moduled at frequencies less than 25 Hz, which the human eye can detect as a variation in the lamp intensity of a standard bulb due to sudden changes in the real and reactive power drawn by the load. So it is nothing but voltage change that can be observed from human eye, and it is nothing but flicker. Cases of voltage flicker: induction motor drive, arc furnaces, arc welders, frequent motor starts, and effects. Effects is lamp flicker. Human eye is most sensitive to voltage waveforms modulation around a frequency of 6 to 8 hertz. Now, voltage notching. We can observe the in this waveform. Here is voltage notching is there. Here we can also observe the voltage notching. So, cases of this voltage notching is adjustable speed drives, solid state drives, etc. Voltage interruption. Complete loss of electrical supply is known as voltage interruption. In this case, here is the in this area complete loss of electrical supply. So we can consider this as a voltage interruption. What are the cases? Transmission fault clearing time, opening or reclosure of circuit breaker. So due to this, the voltage interruption is present in the system. Transient disturbances. Transient disturbances are caused by the injection of energy by switching or by lighting. Cases, so lighting, capacitor switching, and load switching. In the waveform, here we can observe the transient disturbances. Need for power quality. Business problems. Momentary disturbance can cause scrimmed data, interrupted communications, system crashes, and equipment failure. Lost productivity and idle people and equipment. Overtime required to make up for lost work time. Revenue and accounting problems such as invoices not prepared, payments held up, etc. So these are the business problems. According to Electric Light and Power magazine, 30 to 40% of all business downtime is related to power quality problems. So we can see the importance of power quality. IEEE 519 harmonic standard. See, IEEE 519 is the standard, it stands for harmonic limits in any system. So according to this standard, we can limit the harmonic in any system. Power quality mitigation. So these are the all issues, and we can mitigate these issues with different type of remedies. First, reactive and harmonic demand. This can be mitigated by active filter and passive filter. Voltage sag and swell. So, dynamic voltage restorer and tap changing transformer. Voltage unbalance. Static power balancer, redistribution of single phase loads equally to all phases, utility level, and load balancing plant level. So these are the remedies for voltage unbalance. Voltage flicker, distribution static VR compensator. Transient disturbances, surge arrestor, isolation transformer, active or passive filter. These are the remedies for transient disturbances. So this is all about power quality issues. Thank you.